Hello, this is Carmondale 549, starting a one grid simple route for Trainz New Era. I'm going to show some track laying and certain techniques. Video, I'm not sure how long it's going to be. It's how to lay simple track plans for people who are starting out. Started with a tane track wood. I like the features of this track because when one lays out the junctions, I can see the rail frogs. Set the track at a roughly a 45 degree angle. I'm gonna set the track height. Start out with the base. For my parallel tracks, I'll hold the shift key down. So the spline points don't capture each other. I believe this setting is so I like to add my own junctions. Right now I set up the edge of the vertex roughly to the edge of the rail ties. Every time I add a junction I have to do the spline straighten tool. If you look closely, you can see the built-in frogs. Grid point is leveled. Started with a simple runaround track. I have not decided to base track height is 0.75 meters above the baseboard. I might do a simple track plan with, we'll have very tight turns. I've decided to maybe have two reverse loops on the route. Since this is very small, the radius of the turns will be very sharp. Just cut in another vertex blind point because these turns are very sharp. Generally, I use the 5 meter grid lines. Usually, for a parallel track, I have the vertex right in the center of the grid line. This one is the black center grid line, and I'm about to lay another track over the yellow grid line. Here's not, I'm not sure whether to put a yard here because I have a passing track. We are back after station identification. Can you hear me now? Because I've got Verizon cell phone service. Wanted to see how much room. I usually leave roughly each yellow square is 5 meters. Usually have a minimum of roughly 25 meters minimum between the center of the track and the edge of the baseboard. Now for the south side of the S-curve. Pretty tricky. It's not much clearance if I'm using just one grid tile. Should work better. Thank you. minimum. I usually run the minimum crossovers. Is roughly 3 squares. Can be very tight, but 3 squares is 15 meters. Sometimes for this, I'll go to 20 meters. For this crossover, I added some spline points. Alright, add the turnout section of the track. Whenever you see an orangish red vertex, it means that angle isn't correct. Appears not to work. After this, I remove the hair. There you have it. There's a crossover between the tracks. S curbs need a small short section of straight track so the rail trucks can transition over the turn. I'm deciding what I should use for the turnout throws. That motorized US and S switch machines are great for modern routes, and they have the switch stand medium cylinder. Sometimes I like to use those because I like to see the targets. For this one, I'll use the switch stand short frame number 2. I see that there's the junction there. On crossovers, I like to see the target facing on the outside of the track. There you go, first set of pair of junctions. To switch the junctions, there's the window with the 3 arrows. To throw the switch, look for the window with the 3 arrows that says junction direct control. In quotation marks J. Here's the first crossover. Run around track. Usually I put down a track mark. To adjust the trigger, go on the advanced tab, and I click on set trigger radius. This one I'll put, I believe it's 12 meters. Right now, I'm putting up a siding for a small industry with a drill track. Using a track stopper TTR, one rusty. I'm gonna lay them out. I have to make sure the bumpers are facing the correct way. For now, I'm gonna use a track mark trigger. I will label it Industry A. I'm gonna place a few signals on the route, just simple dwarf signals. Process. I'm going to do a little test drive on this route. I'm almost ready to go. I'm gonna do some experimenting. Alright, here's your edit session menu. Now we will do a test drive. Houston, we have a problem.
Thank you.